Funeral in my brain. The mourners to and fro. The kept treading. Treading until it seemed the sense was breaking through. And then when everyone was seated, a service like a drum kept beating, beating until I felt my mind was going numb. And then I heard them lift a box and creep across my soul with those same boots of lead again. The space began to talk. Emily Dickinson is able to convey into language what is depression. To some, depression means nothing, it's just a word. But depression is the leading cause of disability in the world. And because it's a mental illness, it's far harder to understand than, say, high cholesterol. It feels like tend to think of a pervasive damp. A dragonfly won't let up day after day. But depression often manifests itself as something entirely different. Things like I have aches. Pains. Memory lapses. Constant reoccurring headache. These unusual symptoms are actually quite common and can be masking depression, delaying an important diagnosis. Things like trouble sleeping, loss of energy, fatigue, concentrating, remembering, overeating, not eating enough, a loss of sexual desires. Could all be manifesting due to stress, anxiety, and/or depression. We all go through periods of deep, meaningful sadness and grief, and those feelings usually fade away within a few days to a couple of weeks, depending on the circumstances. But a profound sadness, a sadness that lasts for more than 2 weeks and is affecting your ability to function, may be a sign of depression. You can have some of these symptoms. You can have some symptoms that are not on this list. Bearing in mind, it is also possible from time to time to have some of these symptoms without having depression. There are 7.7 billion people in the world as of July 2019. 300 million people have depression, and it affects all ages, race, colour, creed, and social economics. It is estimated that 15% of the adult population will experience depression at some point in its lifetime. Depression affects women far more than it does men, with women attempting suicide twice as often, and men being 4 times as likely to die from suicide. 40% of those who have died from suicide have made one previous attempt, for suicide is the second leading cause of death in the world for those aged 15 to 24 years old, with around 800,000 deaths worldwide each year. That's one death every 40 seconds. Now, there are known and effective treatments in the world, and yet, fewer than half, and in some countries, fewer than 10%, receive such care. Barriers to effective care include a lack of resources, lack of healthcare providers, and the social stigma associated with the mental disorders. People suffering from a major depression experience symptoms most of the day, every day. And like many mental health conditions, it has little to do with what's happening around them. They can have a dream job, tons of friends, and a loving family. They can have the kind of life that we all look at and envy, and still have depression. Even if there's no logical reason for their depression, that does not mean that it does not exist, and that they can simply tough it out. So what can we do? We do not blame people for their physical ailments. So we should not be blaming people for their mental ones. The symptoms and treatments of depression are far more complex. But let's not let that which we do not understand stop us from being there for those who we love. Thank you very much for your time.